Hi guys, his name is Johnson, and first I'd like to say Happy New Year to everybody. Hope you guys had a productive year, and if you didn't have a productive, and if you did have a productive year, what I want to do is just encourage you not to get depressed, not to get discouraged, and not try to do it all in 2012. Remember, success is not judged year by year, but over the lifetime of what God's called you to do. So I want you to continue doing what God's called you to do, and not try to overdo it in 2012, but really just do what God's called you to do. But more on 2012 later. First, what I want to do is kind of go through what I call a year-end review of 2011 and just talk a little bit about what happened in 2011. So in 2011, I kind of was going hard at this ideal of helping Christian entrepreneurs develop God-inspired businesses. And I was doing it through a combination of interviews, which is called a Christian Entrepreneur Show, writing articles, the Blunt Training Center, and video blogs. And so let's give you a little quick stats of what happened on the website. So a lot of stuff was done online. So we had 3,319 unique visitors actually visit the website. They generated 22,483 page views, and that equivalent, so that's a lot of page views for the year. It's not much as other websites, but it's pretty good for the Christian entrepreneur space. We averaged about 530 visits per month. Those visits came from 88 countries and territories. And I know it comes from a lot of countries because I actually had an advisement call from somebody from Trinidad that needed some help with their business. All right, so let's on to the next one, the Christian Entrepreneurship Show. We currently have 54 episodes, and in 2011, the show was viewed 4,800 times, and we had 1,170 listeners. And this year, in 2011, we did 28 interviews. The next thing we had was the Biblical Entrepreneur Training Center. Right now, we currently have 61 articles. Of those articles, 61 articles, they were read 7,340 times, and we had 1,726 readers. All right, so that was the stats for the Training Center. So that's pretty cool in terms of the Training Center. Video blogs. Video blogs was new for 2010, so I've got total 68 videos right now on YouTube. And on my website, I have 2,882 page views for the videos, which means that people clicked on the pages, not necessarily watched them, just clicked on the pages. But on the YouTube, people who actually watched the video, the YouTube video count was 2,322 for an entire YouTube video count. Another thing we started, so that's pretty cool. So I just started 2010, got over 2,000 video views on YouTube. So 2012, we're gonna try to get those numbers up higher. Another thing I started this year was a God Idea Lab, which is a virtual business incubator for Christian entrepreneurs to help them develop what God's called them to do. And so far, I started in October, and so far we have three members of the lab group. And I'll be looking to expand our membership more in 2012. Now, some of the most popular content from the website was, here's the three most popular things. I wrote an article that says, it was called 25 Things You Need to Know to Have a Successful Marriage, and that was read 258 times. The next thing that was most popular was a podcast I did from the Christian Entrepreneur Show from Shannon Nelson, was how do you recover financially if your husband leaves you and the kids? Now, Shannon's husband actually left her and the kids, and she had to build a business from what God's called her to do, and her story was listened to 237 times on the Christian Entrepreneur Show. The next piece that was the most interested was, without a successful marriage, your business is in trouble. And those read 194 times. Kind of what I'm noticing from my website is that, you know, I'm doing videos, I'm doing interviews. Really, what's the most popular content is actually my articles. So I may have to kind of ramp that up in terms of the article writing. You know, that's probably the hardest to produce is the articles, but that's the most interesting. And probably because search engines love articles, it's bringing a lot of search engine traffic for those actual articles. Which goes into the last category I want to talk about was, Google sent a lot of traffic this year to me, and most of the traffic was based around this ideal of, should Christians work with non-Christians? That was literally the most popular search term that was driving traffic to my website. I wrote an article called Should Christians and Non-Christians Work Together in Business, and that article was read 193 times, but a lot of search traffic was going towards that particular article. Which tells me a lot of Christian entrepreneurs are kind of interested in this topic of, should I work with non-Christians? So that's kind of the year-end review, and it's not a bad start for 2011. I started this thing in 2010, kind of around June 2010, And now I had a full year, 2011, actually doing it. And so this is kind of, I consider the start of what God is calling me to do. And so now let's talk about 2012. I'm gonna put the iPad down a little bit. Let's talk about 2012. Now 2012, what the word of the Lord to me for 2012 for me is be profitable in 2012. Now that was the word that was bubbling in my spirit since October was the ideal. In 2012, God wants me to be profitable, and God wants other Christian entrepreneurs that's following me, following what we're doing, to be profitable. Now, my bishop on New Year's Eve, he gave the great word that really confirmed what God was telling me. His word for the year for us was God's gonna open windows of opportunities in 2012, and that fit in perfectly what God was calling me, telling me about 2012, was that this is the year of being profitable. This is the year of doing what God has called you to do and being very profitable doing that. And so, which means that we gotta strip away a lot of the stuff that's bogging up our time and really trust God and focus in on doing what he's called us to do. And so for me, what I've had to do is I literally had to shut down some businesses in 2011 that I'm really not gonna take into 2012. It's gonna really free up time for me to truly focus in on what God's called me to do. And I'm really, and I, how can I say, it's kind of hard to say. It's like, you know, I tell people to do what God's called them to do. Sometimes I'm guilty of trying to do other stuff than what God's called me to do. And I think I've been guilty of that. Because what God's really called me to do is really to build a business around helping Christian entrepreneurs develop what God's called them to do. You know, even though I've been doing it in 2012, I was doing a lot of other side projects because I was trying to generate revenue from these side projects versus trying to focus in on really making this a successful business. So what God has prompted me to do for 2012 was that it's time for me to officially recognize that what I'm doing, and the word he gave me was a for-profit ministry. I have a for-profit ministry of helping Christians develop businesses that God has called them to. Now, the reason God wanted me to call it a for-profit ministry, he didn't want me to build a business that relied on offerings. Because if I had a business or a ministry that was based on offerings, then it's really not a business anymore. What businesses do is that business create value and they trade it for value. And the value you need to trade it for is money. So what I have to do is I got to create a business around this ministry of helping you develop your business. And so as I create value, they will trade it with value from other areas. So for example, the first thing I created value was the God Idea Lab. Now the God Idea Lab is $47 a month for people to join the lab. And that is value that I created that people trade revenue to me for. So in 2012, I'm gonna do more stuff like that and actually building a business around helping Christian entrepreneurs develop their business. And I really in the last few days really got confident in saying, hey, this is what I'm called to do. I've known it's what I'm called to do, but now I know I gotta build a business around what I'm called to do. So for you guys out there too, and let's listen to me now, what God has called to do, I think in 2012, it's time for us to stop playing around with it and really build a business out of it. You know, no longer make it a hobby, no longer make it a side gig, but put it front and center, number one, and say, okay, this is what you called me to do. Now I'm gonna trust you to increase through what I'm called to do. And I think it's a hard thing to do sometimes. You gotta put your faith out there, gotta put your trust out there. But I think in 2012, for us to be profitable, we gotta actually do that. And so 2012, be profitable in 2012, be profitable in 2012. And I know it's a long video because it's kind of first of the new year, and I kind of wanna share what happened last year and what's going on this year. And another thing I'm gonna do in terms of building a business, one of the first things you do when you build a business, you gotta expand your message. So businesses that create the most revenue are businesses that touch the most people. And for what I'm called to do, helping Christian entrepreneurs, I gotta expand my base of the people I help and the people I reach out to with a message. I was doing some quick research. Now, if you type in the phrase Christian entrepreneurship, and if you look that up on Google, that's only searched about 1,500 times in the entire planet. So the entire world is only searching for the phrase Christian entrepreneurship 1,500 times. If you type in the word Christian business, that's only like 40,000 people out of the entire world is searching for the phrase Christian business. So that tells me that I can have an online only strategy of reaching Christians to help them develop their business, which means that in 2012, I'm going to start conducting a lot more workshops where I'm going to go into local churches and really teach the members of those local churches how to start businesses and how to flow through what God's called them, their particular passion. And I'm still going to be doing online too, you know, videos, articles, interviews every week. But also I got to take that energy and I got to bring it to the ground games, I call it, to the churches, because most people are not searching online for this stuff. So I got to take it to the places where people need it the most, and that's where it is. Because like in Jesus' ministry, he said he was preaching and teaching in their synagogues. Jesus wouldn't just create a website and start teaching just from the website. He had to go where the people are, and for what I'm called to, I kind of got to go where the people are. So if you want to invite me to your church, I'm here for you to conduct a workshop. We could do them on Saturdays, or we could do it in afternoons. If we do it here in a metro Atlanta area, we could do it in afternoons. But if we're outside the Atlanta area, we got to do it on the weekends. All right, so I know I'm rambling a little bit, but I'm just excited about 2012. I want you to get excited about your business. And this is Amos Johnson. I want you to be profitable in 2012. Talk to you guys later.